Now see, page 74, pick of thrones and the elephants. Mughal emperors commissioned an illustrated manuscript to record their reigns as well as to document translation of the text and poetry. What these Mughal emperors did, you know? Commissioned means what? Paid artist. They called the paid artist. Means they gave money. Though artist means you know, no? Then poet money for their work. Now see, artist, they will draw the pictures of the Mughals. They will draw the picture of Taj Mahal. They will draw the picture of Buland Darwaza. They will draw the picture of what is there in Delhi? Qutub Minar. So that is, who is required? Artist. And to write poems. Artists can write the poems? No. They require poets to be poets. Those who are poet, Kavi, to write about it. Why did they do so, like that? To keep the record. To keep the record. Now you tell me, is Babur alive now? If you want to know about Babur Nama, can you call him and ask him? Are there any person who can tell all the story? You have your living certificate. Why? Because of your name, your birth date, your caste, your father's name, your mother's name, in which class you are studying. Correct? You have Aadhaar card.
Yes.
Same way, to keep the record of the history from the day the Nawabs have started, these people, Mughal emperors, commissioned many illustrated manuscripts. Commissioned many illustrated manuscript means they brought the paid artist. They brought the poet, they told them to write, and they paid them the money. Illustrated means filled with paintings and pictures. Only the poet will do? Only the writer will do? No. There is, now see, for example, I can tell you, parts of the body is written in this class here. If you only put the parts of body will do? Some may know, some may not know. Parts of body is very easy. But if there is a big picture of skeleton, sapla rehta hai malum hai na, and the parts of that body is mentioned, without somebody has written, can you understand? No, that is why this Mughal emperor brought the artist. Not understanding? Artist. And also the people to write. But did they do the work in free? No, put your leg down and sit as if you are sitting in the class. You don't know how to sit in the class. Sit straight. And they paid them for their work. Akbar, who himself enjoyed painting. See, every person has some hobby. Some have a hobby of dancing, singing, playing cards, painting, playing music instruments. So Akbar had what? He himself enjoyed painting, employed more than 100 artists. Did he call only 3-4 children? Like I am doing one chart, only 2 children come here. No. To make it on a great extension, he called for how many people? More than? A fascinating painting of Akbar, dated round about 1595, shows him having a spiritual awakening, a hunt in Punjab. Kneeling, he is gazing at the corpse on of Himalaya blue sheep and orders the hunt to be stopped. Now see here. What has happened? Akbar, who himself was enjoyed painting, employed more than 100 artists. A fascinating painting of Akbar. Fascinating means very interesting, very nice, very enjoyable. Of Akbar, dated around 15 to 221? No. dated around 1595. As it is now 2021, 1595, you see the theme, isn't it? Shows him having a spiritual awakening. Spiritual awakening means dharmic utsukta, religious thinking in him. What religious thinking? During a hunt in Punjab, what happened? There was a hunt in Punjab. What is the meaning of hunt? Shikari. They might be hunting the wild animals. Kneeling, he is gazing at the corpse of Himalaya's blue sheep and orders the hunt to be stopped. And see, it is little bit historical. You will feel bored. What has happened here? When he saw corpse of hunting, means the group, people hunting blue sheep at the feet of Himalaya. So he had spiritually awakening, dharmic bhavana thi usme, isme akbar mein. So you will see that picture, he is kneeling down and what he is doing? He is gazing at the corpse of a Himalayan blue sheep and orders the hunt to be stopped. So what these hunters were doing in Himalayas? What this hunter was doing in Himalayas? Hunting blue sheep. So since he had dharmic bhavana, he had spiritual awakening in him, he was gazing at these hunters, the way they are hunting, they are killing the animals, and he requested them to kill more animals.
No.
He requested them to stop hunting. Is it clear to you? And when you are at home, now it will complete very soon, but remember, when I stop the lesson, you have to mark there and keep, because you come the other day, you don't know what I have taught in the class. But when you are there, you can hear me clearly. The recording is clearly. Then you must see the last line of the recording and you must mark. Huh? This incident, according to Abul Fazl, who wrote the Akbarnama, the history of Akbar reign. Mansi. Now this incident means jo ye hua, ye jo cheez hui, which they were hunting the sheep, blue sheep, and Akbar couldn't see. He could not tolerate. He kneeled down and he told them to stop. Now who has written this incident? According to Abul Fazl, he was also, who was he? Maybe a poet, correct?
Yes.
Who wrote Akbarnama? Akbarnama means, I told you, the history about
Akbar.
Baburnama, history of
Babur.
Huh? Shubranama means a story of
Shubra.
So, the history of Akbar's reign deeply strengthened his belief that he had a spiritual calling from God. And when this Abul Fazl wrote Akbarnama, he wrote the history, he had deeply strengthened his belief, means his belief, whose belief? No, his belief, whose writing? Huh? His belief deeply strengthened his belief that he had a spiritual calling from God. Spiritual, dharmikta ka pukar. Kisse mila tha Akbar ko?
God
said. Or you have sent, I have sent? No. Who came to know this?
God.
What are you talking, my dear?
Abul Fazl
came to know. Abul Fazl came to know that he had, what did he have? Spiritual calling from
God.
Spiritual calling from God. Spiritual means, you know, spiritual things. All dharmikta. So spiritual awakening, spiritual lightning, Akbar had got from God. This illustrated manuscript commissioned by the emperors tended to emphasize the heroic achievement. Now see, we'll go one word by word. Doesn't matter if it takes another two periods. The illustrated manuscript. Illustrated means what? Filled with painting and picture. For example, one page filled with painting and picture. See, this illustrated manuscript. You understood this? Commissioned means what? You also know that paid artist and the poet money for their writing. Work they did by the empress to intend to tend it to emphasize. What is the meaning of emphasize? Give special importance. I am teaching you, children, please emphasize on this. Means what? You give importance on this. I am not dancing here. I am not singing. I am not telling you a story. I am explaining you a lesson. So emphasize on this lesson. So what had happened? The illustrated manuscripts commissioned by the emperors brought the artist, paid the poet, tended to emphasize, to give importance their heroic achievement. What did they emphasize? What did they say to put power on that, to give importance on that, about the heroic achievement? Heroic achievement means what? What is heroic achievement? What the work, the big deeds they have done. Okay, now for example I will tell. Now see, I have taken you to the ground. Okay, and a snake comes. Girls will run shouting, eh, kah, pah, pah, like that. Correct? But boys kill the snake. All boys together got together and kill the snake. Atano took one piece home. So what happens? What did the boy do? They showed the heroic deeds. Forget about snake. These boys are there near the gate and they saw a dog chasing a girl, or a girl is fallen in the tank of the school. All the boys jumped into the tank, removed the girl, or removed one boy's fallen, removed the boy. What happened? You are laughing. Now a girl falls in the tank, what you'll say? Ladki re mat utha usko marne de udhar chale. No, you have to save the life. Maybe a girl or boy. Today's world, today's days, today's time, girls, boys are same. Girls are more than the boys. Because boys don't want to study, girls study, isn't it? And see, on the big post you will find girls mostly nowadays.
Yes.
So girl fallen in the water or a boy fallen in the water, boys jumps, the peons will jump, they will remove him. They will see that he's well. That is a heroic deed. Heroic power. Understood? Means? This is simple. But these kings, emperors must have done a big achievements, important things. That is known as heroic deeds or heroic importance. Achievements. They also tell us that the Mughal period was the struggle for power and terrible cruelty. Now at the sea, same time, in this poet's return, in Babur Nama, Akbar Nama, whatever they have written, they also say that Mughal period was the struggle. Means struggle, you know what is the meaning of struggle? To fight, to get over it. Ji jaan se ladna. But and terrible cruelty. Though they were struggling for power, you understand? Struggling for power means what? One person is having power. I am a principal. Or this I'll tell you. Somebody wants to become principal and he will find out he will do some cruelty things. This is little topper to you, but I'll show you. There is one boy coming first in the class. There is one girl coming first in the class. What will happen? Another boy, girl, he wants to come first. He's struggling to come first. The girl is struggling to come first, but that boy who's coming first, the girl who's coming first, should not come first, so the other children do some cruelty. They rob their notebooks during exam. They rob their textbook, or they will take the book and throw away. So they are struggling for power. What power to come first? But the others don't want them to come first. They want to come, or some other want to come. So there is a cruelty also. Have you understood this?
Yes.
How can we forget? How can we forget how Khushrau was blinded on his father Jahangir's order? Now see, there was Khushrau, named Khushrau. He was blinded. Usko andha kar diya tha. Usko kya kar diya tha?
Andha.
By his father Jahangir's order. Now you tell me. One boy is there. Your father will order to stretch a dole forunta. So lay ikada tikada bakto. Will your father say, to he is going and standing near the window, khidkit jaun ubharaton bayar bakto, abhyas nikarte cha dole forunta. Will he? Will I tell my somebody to kill my, make my son blind? Nay. But here there was such a cruelty also. Why? Jahangir might have thought ki that Khushrau might do something for him. You are understanding? Khushrau is son. Jahangir is his father. Cruelty might have come to his mind. Buradiyo, vichar uske dil mein aaya hoga. Kya mera beta mere raj pe kuch to bhi karega. He will do something. So he ordered, go and kill that Atharvazari. Go and make him blind. So what will happen? All the thing Atharva's father will do. Isn't it? Bas cooperate karna. You are understanding? And later killed on the orders of Prince Khurram. And then later, first he was made blind. And later, we don't want this all in your hand. Please remove it. Just now you remove it. You are not come for wedding. This Bali, Bili, we don't want in the ears. Please. Okay, now see. First he was made blind. Andha kiya gaya. On order of who?
Jahangir.
Who was Jahangir?
His father.
And then, later, on the orders of Prince Khurram, he was
killed.
Killed yani pura maar diya. Theek hai? Who took the title of Shahjahan? And who took the title of? He killed him, and Khurram took the title of Shahjahan. Shahjahan then ordered the killing of all his male relations. Then what happened? Shahjahan, Khurram became Shahjahan after killing Khushrau. Then Shahjahan ordered killing all his male relations, in order to make sure that there was no other contender for the throne. So no, see, very bad. They were struggling for power. All the Mughal emperors were very good. They have given us many monuments, many good places, big, big gardens. But they had cruelty also in them. Dushtata. Will you kill your brothers?
No.
Will your fathers kill your sons?
No.
Their sons? No. So this Shahjahan ordered killing all male relations, no girls. He ordered what? Go and kill all the male, jitne bhi ladke hai, unko jaake maar dalo. Kyun? Why? So that, in order to make that there was no other contender for the throne. It was other time that the queens like Jhansi Ki Rani, Ahilyabai Holkar, they became later. But before, who was there? All the male members of the. You understand what is male and female?
Yes.
You are male and you are female.
No.
your male and female. I was looking the same.
So, if now you see, if there is any male in his relation, he may become big, or this fellow Sajan may die, or Sajan might be killed by his male relative, and they will take the throne. मगर जब घर में मेल ही नहीं है तो who will be the king forever? Yes. Then there was Ashraf Khan. Now see, now another person is come now. Ashraf Khan. Who had his sister? Noor Jahan. Then there was Ashraf Khan who had his sister Noor Jahan, Jahangir's widow. Jahangir's widow means what? Widow means what? You know what is the meaning of widow? A married lady. A married lady, a married girl, and her husband dies. Jahangir's widow. Noor Jahan's name was what? Noor Jahan. See, then there was Ashraf Khan who had his sister. Noor Jahan, Jahangir's widow, arrested. Who was arrested? Jahangir Khan's widow. Also Aurangzeb, who had executed Dara, the eldest son of Shah Jahan, so that he could reign supreme. Now see, Noor Jahan was arrested. If she is arrested, can she become a queen?
No.
No, she is in the jail. Then Aurangzeb, everybody knows Aurangzeb?
Yes.
This Karni goes to meet Aurangzeb, always to Aurangzeb. You met him? She goes to Aurangzeb, her mama's place is Aurangzeb, no? So your mama didn't show me, take you to meet Aurangzeb? No, he's died, huh? Who had executed Dara, the eldest son of Sajan? Who was Dara, eldest son of?
Sajan.
He also executed him, caught him, so that he could reign supreme. Mother is in the jail, son he had executed, caught him, put him and somewhere else, so that Aurangzeb will have the supreme power. Please mark and keep it here.